The 28th Universiade, the biggest sports event of the summer. More than 10,000 athletes and officials from around the world traveled to Gwangju in South Korea to take part in a 12-day festival of sport. It was organized under the auspices of FISU, the International University Sports Federation. Here's the Universiade director, Mark van den Plas.
Au niveau de la FISU, je pense que c'est vraiment une très grande réussite.
I think that for FISU, it's been a great success. Just ask the athletes and the heads of delegations who all said that it was an immense success. And for us, the athletes and the heads of delegations are the most important people. We had the athletes' village that worked very well. We had competitions of a very high level with a very high number of athletes and officials, nearly 11,000 altogether. We had sports performances at a very high level as well with exceptional competitions. So the results are really positive. Positive, and we are really very, very happy. Altogether, there were 21 sports at the Universiade. It was hard work for the organizers who had to schedule the program of open air sports under the permanent threat of rain and even violent thunderstorms.
It's always very difficult to find dates that don't coincide with the dates of major international events. The organizing committee wanted to hold the games in early July, and I must say that we were lucky, because at the beginning of July, the rainy season starts in Korea. But in the end, it only rained for 3 days of the competition. So Lady Luck really did smile on us. And it was one of the big points of the whole affair.
In athletics, bad weather or not, there were some excellent performances, like the three gold medals of Victoria Zyabkina of Kazakhstan, a third title in a row for Pavel Fajdek of Poland in the hammer throw, the new Universiade record in the steeplechase for Katerina Sokolenko, the victory of her Russian compatriot Katerina Koneva in the triple jump, and Pavel Shalin in the long jump. But one of the most impressive victories came in the decathlon from Thomas van der Platsen.
Everybody was saying that it was going to be incredibly difficult or even impossible to get back in 6 months. And I proved them wrong. And I mean, it just goes to show that there's so many possibilities in life as long as you just keep pushing yourself and keep dreaming big.
Thomas's comeback story was quite remarkable.
Being here is probably the biggest victory of them all. That's why I think it was very important for me to kind of take away that whole block of training I did to get back into shape and get here from the competition itself. Like, I think just being here is the victory on its own.
Why? Thomas was the decathlon champion at the last university games in Kazan. But in September last year, the young Belgian was diagnosed with testicular cancer. His treatment worked just in time for Gwangju.
I think the university games came like at the perfect moment, because I've only felt the last 2-3 weeks that I was actually getting in shape, like getting strong enough for decathlon. So it was like just that perfect timing for me to step back into the ring.
He'd had to go through so much. He'd finished his chemotherapy not long before arriving in Gwangju. Now he would try to rekindle the energy and the will to compete at a decent level.
I felt like the tension was like a bit more loaded now that I came back after such a long period of being sick. Like, there was like more weighing on myself, kind of, because I worked so hard to come back. Like, I set more expectations for myself just because I had to work so hard. So I think after the first few events, I told myself, like, okay, you need to see what you did in training the last 6 months.
10 different disciplines over a period of 2 days. A tough schedule for anybody. And Thomas didn't start well, way behind over the 100 meters, and the worst performance of his life in the long jump. But he kept fighting. And somehow, he found the will and the power to claw his way back up the leaderboard. And finally, he would win gold in this, the toughest event in athletics.
Wow. when I actually pulled away for that gold medal, everybody was showing like a lot of respect, and everybody congratulated me, and like I could see the deepest respect when they were congratulating me. So that really felt good, because I mean, I was out there for 2 days with those guys, and I could see they went through hell as well to just finish this decathlon. And I mean, it just feels great to be among them and to just get that respect for having fought so hard to get back here.
For Thomas van der Pletsen, these university games will always be special. South Korea launched him back up into the world of competitive athletics.
This medal just finishes the story of me like working hard to get back and like never doubting that I could do this. So it's just like the perfect end to this chapter of my life, like the chapter of trying to get back to what I love, like the athletics.
Thomas van der Pletsen, a champion larger than life, one of the heroes of the Universiad.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.